Welcome back again. In this section, we're going to take a look about PPP multi-link bundling, as we have discussed. As I shared you in previous video, that in upcoming video, we will discuss this one. So now let first understand why we're going to discuss multi-link bundling. So actually, this is not part of your exam. If you're talking about a PPP multi-link bundling, this is not part of your CCNP 2.0 root exam. But for verification, for bonus video, I'm going to share you the basic configuration of PPP link bundling. So in order to make your combine your multiple interface work as a logical interface like Ether channel inside your LAN, we need to use PPP multi-link bundling. So basically, it aggregates your speed, actually, I should say. So you may have a couples of link which is going to the same direction, like if you have a branch router and another is HQ router. So suppose you have a multiple link goes to the same direction, you can combine into single logical interface, and then after you can perform aggregate your speed. You can perform load balancing, I should say. So configuration is straightforward. This is not all about, but yes, this is basic to understand how does your multi-link bundling work over PPP. So the serial this is the serial interface encapsulation PPP, and we also need to tell we're going to use as a multi-link. And then what is the group number which you want to participate? So suppose in this case we have two serial interface. Both serial interface has identical information that they're running PPP and they are ready for multi-linking and they are part of group one. Similarly, on right hand side, group one. And this is actually locally significant. You can put here group number 2, 3 and whatever you want. But make sure whatever group number you're going to create should be identical to your all of physical link which you want to combine. As well as there is a logical interface which going to create in order to assign IP address, since we have two interface, on which interface you're going to assign IP address. So you don't need to assign IP address on your physical interfaces. You need to create a multi-link interface and then after assign IP address on it. And here you also need to define going to work as a multi-link, and I am also part of group one. So physical and logical, they working in one group. In whatever parameter you have applied in your logical or multi-link group, this is automatically going to inherit by serial 0 and serial 1. So suppose if you're going to disable CDP, automatically going to disable CDP on these physical interfaces. So let's go through the configuration that makes sense a lot. So in this time, I'm going to use my terminal server. So let's say, actually this is my terminal server, which I use to connect multiple devices in order to get console. And another is my core router D. So this is actually 2.1.2.8.1.1 router, and the iOS is running, I think it is 12.4. Hope so. So let assign this configuration on it. I have also turned on my devices, which is up and ready. So first I would like to show the version. This is 12.2 and this is, you can see at the bottom, Cisco 2811. So in this gear or in this box, I think both are the same. Do so work. Yeah, exactly. both are the same. So next thing which I'm going to do, you can say in my TS terminal server I have a 8 serial interfaces, 8 terminal line interfaces, and so on and so forth. So these two interfaces I'm going to combine from TS, and these two interfaces I'm going to combine from core router D. So start from TS, interface upper one, which is S1/7, no shut down, encapsulation PPP, PPP multi-link, and then after multi-link group, and this time I'm going to use group number 1. The next thing is serial interface S1/5, encapsulation PPP, PPP multilink, and you are also part of group 1. And finally, please no shut down. On another hand, this is core router D. So interface S0 here, let you show what I have connected. Excuse me, do so once. In router D, I think there is 2 serial connection. Yes, there is 4 serial connection. 2T, 1 card. So now it has 4 serial connections. So hop over to the appropriate which you want to configure, 0.0.0.1. No shutdown, encapsulation PPP, PPP multi link, and PPP multi link group number 1. Similarly, on the another interface, which is S0/1/1, encapsulation PPP, PPP multi link. And you are also part of group number 1. So no shut. And let verify do so IP interface brief. The status of interfaces. So one interface is S0/0. Let me use my pencil. One interface is S1/1/1. This is this one. We can see this is up and down. Another one is S0/0/1. This one. This is up actually. So I think I have missed the clock rate on terminal router. I think so. So let me hop over interface S1/5. I think I have already working on it. Clock rate 128.0.0.0. And the interface should going to up. Yes, there it is. Now everything is fine. The next thing which we going to do, going to create a multi-link. So interface multi-link, and whatever multi-link you want to take. So in this case I'm going to use 1 to make this simple, and encapsulation PPP, PPP multi-link also going to use on it, and then this is also part of group number 1, no shut down. The next thing which we need to do, we need to assign IP address on it. So this is the interface, the IP address 1.1.1.1. In your case you can put anything, it doesn't matter. And last thing which is no shut down. Hop over to core router D. So interface multi-link, similarly right there, encapsulation PPP, no shut down, PPP multi-link, and PPP multi-link group number 1. And finally the IP address 1.1.1.2.255.255.255.252. Now check the connectivity. So IP interface brief. First would like to show you the multi-link interface which is up now. Same on TS, do so IP interface brief. this is now up. So check the connectivity using the ICMP. We supposed to have the connectivity from, this is not 10.10.10.2, it should be 1.1.1.2. As we can see, we do have a connectivity. But we also want to verify the configuration. So the command is straightforward. So PPP and then after multilink. So this is bundle name CRD. They automatically going to pick the name. So because I am the TS, I'm going to pick the name from the destination router. So this is name of bundle CRD, actually the name of the remote router. And the remote endpoint router is CRD. Local, which is which is me actually. This is the name of router. And then total bandwidth, load, and all those things. And very bottom you can see the member links are 2 and 2 are active, none of inactive. You can also set how many number of link you want to combine, which is minimum and maximum. So using command. And these are the interface which are going to use for multi-link bundling. No one inactive right now. Similarly, if we hop over to the core router D, and so PPP multi-link, we will see. Now I executed command on core router D, and this is CTS, which is name of my terminal server actually. So endpoint, this router, I am this one, and this is the bandwidth and all those things. And these are the two interface which going to combine, none of these inactive. So next thing which you can also see the negotiation. So let's see, debug PPP negotiation. What I'm going to do, I'm going to turn the physical logical interface down. So configure terminal interface multi-link 1 shut, and then after we can no shut the link. Let's say no shut. We can see right there the negotiation. So let's see from here. So now we going to add bundling to the destination router, and these are the parameters which we can say. So this is output packet which I am going to send. My address is something like this, and so on and so forth. And finally, now we are agree. We are agree. That's why link going to be up. So you can see we also using CDP, C and IPC, which means we can transmit data IPv4 and CDP packet as well. So if you want, you can disable CDP. For example, let's bring it up. No shutdown. I think this is already up. And disable no CDP enable on your virtual interface. We'll see the negotiation regarding your CDP. Now your CDP is closed. And I'm actively looking on CDP since neighbor told me I'm not going to send any packet regarding CDP. So the CDP is closed. Similarly, you can enable IPv6. So IPv6, either you can use enable or you can assign IPv6 address. For example, 1000:1/64, likewise on it. interface multi-link 1 IPv6 address 1000 :\2/64. Now, as we can see, this is IPv6 CP. So earlier it was not negotiated. I'm going to drop, and as I configure, it may take a little bit time. So CDP, I'm going to drop. Yes, as we can see, now we are ready to send and receive IPv6 packet on this interface. So rest of configuration going to be on your virtual interface, which basically means if you want to use authentication, let's see, create a username. The name of user is CRD. So this is CRD. Then password is Cisco. Likewise on CRD computer, username, now this is CTS. CTS, and then password is Cisco. So I have created username and password. I can also apply this on the virtual interface, which is multi-link. So in order to use authentication, we need to switch over multi-link, and then after PPP authentication, whatever you want. In my case, I'm going to use CHAP. Another hand, undebug all, excuse me, you all. On another interface, another hand, excuse me, multi-link group 1, PPP authentication CHAP. So now everything is up. We can see the link is up. So whatever authentication you want to use on multi-link, you can apply on this logical interface. So next thing, we need to verify the connectivity. So 1.1.1.2 is up. Let's send a ping packet. 1.1.1.1. You can see we do have a connectivity. So we also, let's say the configuration, so run section, this is multi-link. This is multi-link, so multi-link group 1, execute command on it, so run section multi-link. So run section interface. There we go. As we can see, this is PPP multi. Where it is actually the interface multi-link 1. And whatever is IP address of that interface, IPv6 address and authentication, and we are agreed to use multi-linking on group number 1. Similarly, we can see on this router, so running config, which is section interface. Now we go through, we can see the rest of thing is identical. No CDP enabled, which basically means we don't want to send any CDP packet over the link. So you can use no CDP, you can use only IPv4 traffic or IPv6. But ultimately, end of the result is we going to combine multiple link. So one more thing which I need to mention, let's say, interface multi-link 1, PPP multi-link, and then links. Using these links, we can specify minimum number of interface which going to combine, or maximum number of interface which we going to combine. For example, maximum we can put 255. Similarly, minimum you can use one of them. Excuse me. Minimum 0 to 255. So in logical interface, which is multi-link, we can configure how many of physical interface going to be the part of single logical interface. So this is all about this video. Thanks for watching.